So what are the best ways to add footage into your timeline? Let's take a look inside today's video. Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm showing you three different ways that you can start adding clips to your timeline more efficiently. The first method is using the source panel to create your in and out points and then drag it into the timeline. The second method is using icon view to create a visual storyboard from which you can create your in and outs and drag them all into your timeline. And the third method is using artificial intelligence. That's right, a robot that can identify the different parts of the clips that are shaky and stable and put them inside of your timeline for you. So these are just three methods that you can choose from, and hopefully you'll find them useful. Not one way is better than the other. As usual, I put time codes down below so you can skip ahead to review a certain section just by clicking on the time code below. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. So the first method is creating your in and out points on your footage. This is what is called creating your selects, the areas of the footage that are the most usable that you want to use in your final edit. Now, these in and out points don't have to be perfect because you can further refine your cuts inside your timeline. And I made a full video, 6 ways to edit and trim your clips in your timeline, so you guys can watch that after you watch this video. The first thing is make sure that you're in the assembly layout inside of Premiere Pro. This will make the project panel bigger for organization before you start editing in your timeline. Simply double-click on a clip that you want to open up in the source monitor. Then from here, you can play back the clip and press I on your keyboard to select your endpoint, which is the starting point. Then you can scrub to the point where you want your select to end and press O to set it as the out point. Then you can click on this video and drag it into your timeline. So then you would just repeat this process for all of the clips until you get everything in your timeline. Let's move on to option number 2. The second method is also manual, but it's a bit faster. First, we're going to change the view in our project panel to the icon view, and then you can rescale the thumbnails to the size that makes it easy for you to make your selects. From here, you can visually see all of your clips, preview them, and select your in and out points just by dragging them into the new location with your mouse. So you can make your selects to all of the clips, and then you can move the clips in the order that you want them to be in your timeline. So doing this creates a really cool visual storyboard so you can see which clip goes first, which clip goes next, all the way to the last clip. Then to place all of these clips in your timeline at once, select the first clip, hold shift on your keyboard, and select the last clip. Then drag them all into your timeline. And then this is just the starting point for your rough cut or the montage that you're working on. So this third method is rough cut, which is the AI assistant editor that's available from AE Scripts. Now, Rough Cut did sponsor today's video, but they did not tell me what to say. They were like, hey, just try out this plugin and let us know what you think of it. So Rough Cut, the way it works is it will analyze your footage and identify the shaky and stable parts, doing all of the more labor-intensive work for you, so that way you don't have to go through manually and identify those parts. So how does it work and how do you install it? Go to their website and you can start by just using their trial version. Just hit try from the AE Scripts website and this will download a .zxp file. So you need to have a .zxp file manager to install this, like ZXP installer. So after you have ZXP installer, all you need to do is make sure that Premiere Pro is closed first and then drag the .zxp rough cut file into your .zxp installer. I feel like I just said .zxp a lot, but you get the idea. So once it's installed, you can open up Premiere Pro, go to Window, Extensions, and open up Rough Cut for Premiere Pro. This is going to open up its own window from which you can drag into the same area as the project panel, so it's more easy to use. Then you can also select this hamburger menu from the top of the panel to buy a license or enter your license code. You can also just move forward with this trial version because it has all of the same features as the fully licensed version. Before we begin to analyze the clips, first click on this gear icon here. And what this will do is it'll enable you to change the cache file location, which is where Rough Cut will store all of the processed temporary files. And you can also change the label color for each category. So you can see that there's red for shake, there's green for stable, and yellow for the scene color. To get started, first we're going to select the videos that you want to process from your project panel. you can see that the footage I have here of this kite surfer here, it's fairly shaky throughout. So I just want to use rough cut to identify the parts that are way too shaky and unusable versus the parts that are okay shaky and I can use them in my rough cut. So once the footage is selected, we're going to go back to the rough cut panel, and here it'll show you how many clips that you've selected in the lower left. Now we can hit analyze and it will begin to process all the clips, identifying the shaky and the stable parts. So once it's done, you're taken to an insert tab where you can then tweak the parameters. So this will allow you to say how shaky of the footage you want included in the clips that are inserted in your timeline. In this case, I want Rough Cut to identify the shaky and the stable parts of the clip. So for each clip, I can lower the threshold of the shake just by changing this parameter. And you see as I lower it down to 10, more of the shaky parts are included. So the red parts here are the shaky parts, and the non-red parts are the stable parts of the clip. So you can also adjust the minimum duration of each of these regions simply by entering in a new value, but I'm just going to use the default here. So then I'm going to select all the clips I want to insert into my timeline, and then I'm going to select the sequence I want them to be inserted into, and then you're going to press insert. And now it'll automatically place all of the shaky and the stable parts of the clips into the timeline. As we play it back in the timeline, you can see that the really shaky parts are red, or rosé, as the label color is called. And let's say that you want to remove some of the shaky parts. This is where I can then select the red clips that I don't want, press Alt on my PC or Option key on my Mac, and then press Delete, and it will ripple delete all of the unwanted clips in the timeline. So Rough Cut will be useful for a lot of B-roll shots, right? It's not going to be a very useful plugin if you have a 60-minute clip of somebody sitting still for an interview, because Rough Cut will help you identify the great parts of shots that have shaky or stable scenes. So if you're doing a walking interview, it might be useful because it'll identify the parts that are more usable for the clip. But the cool part about identifying the shaky and the stable parts is because let's say you want to actually use some of the shaky parts in your footage. You don't want to eliminate them entirely, so it gives you that option. One thing I would really like to see in the panel going forward is the ability to change the threshold of all of the clips at once. Right now you have to do it individually, but I'm sure that they are going to be working on that. And if you have any feedback for the Rough Cut team, just leave a comment below. So I hope these three methods will be useful to you, and I'm sure you can use all three of them in one go. So let me know if this video helped you out by giving this a big thumbs up, and also be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new content. But yeah, that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.